Here we're continuing to look at a target game where apples fall from the top of the screen. We're going to look at a scratch feature called clones that can save us a lot of time in debugging. Let me show you three blocks in the controls tab. Here it says, when I start as a clone. This one says, create clone of myself, so that's this sprite, or I can select another sprite. I can also say, delete this clone. So what is a clone? A clone is really just a copy of a sprite, where all the scripts are identical. Most sprites start with a when green flag is clicked. But what I can do when I create a clone is I make a new sprite, a copy of an old sprite, during my game. So when these copies start, they'll use this hat block when I start as a clone. Let's look at how I can use this block for each of my apples that falls from the top of the screen. So I'll bring this out. Instead of running when the flag is clicked, I'll run when I start as a clone. Instead of running forever, I'll just go once. So I'll get rid of the forever block. So when I start as a clone, I'll hide. I'll wait a random amount of time between 1 and 3 seconds. I'll go to a random spot on the top, and then I'll show myself. I'll repeat until the Y position is less than -190. I'll change Y by -5, moving it down. And then if the mouse is down and this particular apple is touching the fruit selector, which is my cursor, then I'll hide and change the score by 1. So this script starts when I make a new copy of my apple. And there are two ways I know I might be done using this apple. One is if someone clicks on the apple, so the mouse is down and it's touching the fruit selector, then I hide and change the score by 1. If I'm hidden, I'm really done with this clone. So what I can do is I can say, delete this clone. Also, if my apple makes it to the bottom of the screen, so Y position is less than -90, so that's here after the repeat, no one's clicked on me, and I can again delete this clone. So this script looks pretty good. I'll have my fruit selector, my cursor, start these clones or create these clones. In doing so, I'll have it create the clones with random spacing. So I'll get rid of the wait here. That block just told the sprite to wait a random amount of time between 1 and 3 seconds before falling down. Let's look at the scripts for my fruit selector. I already have, when the green flag is clicked, set the score to 0 and forever go to the mouse pointer. I also need to create these clones of the fruit sprite. I can say, create clone of fruit. And then when I double click on this green flag, it will run the hat block that says when I start as a clone for the fruit sprite. I'll go back to the fruit selector. I can actually create many clones of this fruit sprite. What I'll do is I'll create them 1 second apart. Here I repeat 10 times. Each time I wait 1 second, then create a clone of fruit. Let's click on the green flag to see what happens. So 1 second apart, apples should fall from the top of the screen. They choose a random X position, so they're not always falling in the same column. After I've created 10 clones, I'm done. These clones were created 1 second apart, but I could use a random block in here to make it a little less predictable. Here I can go from 0.0 to 1.0. If I include the decimal point, it'll give me a decimal number. So it might pick 0.1, it might pick 0.5, it might pick 0.7216. So it'll pick something between 0 and 1. If I don't include the decimal point, it'll just pick a whole number. So here, let's watch what this does now. So now they're a little bit more randomly spaced. See?